Ezekiel 19 to 21. Moreover, take up a lamentation for the princes of Israel and say, what was your mother, a lioness? She couched among lions, in the middle of the young lions, she nourished her cubs. She brought up one of her cubs, and he became a young lion, and he learned to catch the prey. He devoured men. The nations also heard of him. He was taken in their pit, and they brought him with hooks to the land of Egypt. Now when she saw that she had waited, and her hope was lost, then she took another of her cubs, and made him a young lion. He went up and down among the lions. He became a young lion. He learned to catch prey. He devoured men. He knew their places and laid waste their cities. And the land was desolate with its fullness because of the noise of his roaring. Then the nations attacked him on every side from the provinces. They spread their net over him. He was taken in their pit. They put him in a cage with hooks and brought him to the king of Babylon. They brought him into strongholds so that his voice should no more be heard on the mountains of Israel. Your mother was like a vine in your blood, planted by the waters. It was fruitful and full of branches. By reason of many waters, it had strong branches. For the scepter of those who ruled, their stature was exalted among the thick boughs. They were seen in their height with the multitude of their branches, but it was plucked up in fury. It was cast down to the ground, and the east wind dried up its fruit. Its strong branches were broken off and withered. The fire consumed them. Now it is planted in the wilderness in a dry and thirsty land. Fire has gone out of its branches. It has devoured its fruit, so that there is in it no strong branch to be a scepter to rule. This is the lamentation and shall be for a lamentation. Now in the seventh year, in the fifth month, on the tenth day of the month, some of the elders of Israel came to inquire of Yahweh, and sat before me. And the word of Yahweh came to me, saying, Son of man, speak to the elders of Israel, and say to them, and tell them, this is what Adonai Yahweh says. It is to inquire of me that you have come. As I live, says Adonai Yahweh, I will not be inquired of by you. Will you judge them, son of man? Will you judge them, cause them to know the abominations of their fathers, and tell them, this is what Adonai Yahweh says, in the day when I chose Israel, and swore to the offspring of the house of Jacob, and made myself known to them in the land of Egypt, when I swore to them, saying, I am Yahweh your God. In that day I swore to them, to bring them out of the land of Egypt, into a land that I have searched out for them, flowing with milk and honey, which is the glory of all lands. I said to them, each of you throw away the abominations of his eyes. Do not defile yourselves with the idols of Egypt. I am Yahweh your God. But they rebelled against me and would not listen to me. They did not all throw away the abominations of their eyes. They also did not forsake the idols of Egypt. When I said I would pour out my wrath on them to accomplish my anger against them in the middle of the land of Egypt, but I acted for the sake of my name, that it should not be profaned in the sight of nations, among which they are, in whose sight I made myself known to them, in bringing them out of the land of Egypt. So I caused them to go out of the land of Egypt, and brought them into the wilderness. I gave them my statutes, and showed them my ordinances, which if a man does, he will live in them. Moreover, also I gave them my Shabbats, to be a sign between me and them, that they may know that I am Yahweh, who sacrifices them. But the house of Israel rebelled against me in the wilderness. They did not walk in my statutes, and they rejected my ordinances, which if a man keeps, he shall live in them. And they greatly profaned my Shabbats. Then I said I would pour out my wrath on them in the wilderness to consume them. But I acted for the sake of my name, that it should not be profaned in the sight of the nations, in whose sight I brought them out. Moreover, also, I swore to them in the wilderness, that I would not bring them into the land which I have given them, flowing with milk and honey, which is the glory of all lands, because they rejected my ordinances, and did not walk in my statutes, and profaned my Shabbats. For their heart was went after their idols. Nevertheless, my eye spared them, and I did not destroy them. I did not make a full end of them in the wilderness. I said to their children in the wilderness, do not walk in the statutes of your fathers, do not observe their ordinances, nor defile yourselves with their idols. I am Yahweh your God. Walk in my statutes, keep my ordinances, and do them. Make my Shabbats holy. They shall be a sign between me and you, that you will know that I am Yahweh your God. But the children rebelled against me. They did not walk in my statutes, did not keep my ordinances to do them, which if a man does, he shall live in them. They profaned my Shabbats. Then I said, I will pour out my wrath on them to accomplish my anger against them in the wilderness. Nevertheless, I withdrew my hand and acted for the sake of my name, that it should not be profaned in the sight of the nations, in whose sight I brought them out. Moreover, I swore to them in the wilderness that I would scatter them among the nations and disperse them through the countries, because they had not executed my ordinances, but had rejected my statutes and had profaned my Shabbats, and their eyes were after their fathers' idols. Moreover, also, I gave them statutes that were not good, and judgments in which they should not live. I polluted them in their own gifts, in that they caused all that opened the womb to pass through the fire, that I might make them desolate, to the end that they may know that I am Yahweh. Therefore, the Son of Man, speak to the house of Israel and tell them, this is what Adonai Yahweh says. Moreover, in this your fathers have blasphemed me, in that they have committed a trespass against me. For when I had brought them into the land which I swore to give to them, then they saw every high hill and every thick tree, and they offered there their sacrifices, and there they presented the provocation of their offering. There they also made their pleasant aroma, and there they poured out their drink offerings. Then I said to them, what does this high place where you go mean? So its name is called Bama to this day. Therefore tell the house of Israel, this is what Adonai Yahweh says. Do you pollute yourselves in the way of the fathers? Do you play the prostitute after their abominations? When you offer your gifts, when you make your sons to pass through the fire, do you pollute yourselves with all your idols to this day? Should I be inquired of by you, house of Israel? As I live, says Adonai Yahweh, I will not be inquired of by you. That which comes into your mind will not be at all, in that you say, we will be as the nation, as the families of the countries, to serve wood and stone. As I live, says Adonai Yahweh, surely with a mighty hand and with an outstretched arm and with wrath poured out, I will be king over you. I will bring you out from the peoples and will gather you out from the countries in which you are scattered with a mighty hand, with an outstretched arm, and with wrath poured out. I will bring you into the wilderness of the peoples, and there I will enter into judgment with you face to face. Just as I entered into judgment with your fathers in the wilderness in the land of Egypt, so I will enter into judgment with you, says Adonai Yahweh. I will cause you to pass under the rod. I will bring you into the bond of the covenant. I will purge you out from among the rebels and those who disobey me. I will bring them out of the land where they live, but they shall not enter into Eretz Yisrael. Then you will know that I am Yahweh. As for you, house of Israel, this is what Adonai Yahweh says. Go, serve everyone his idols, and hereafter also, if you will not listen to me, but you shall no more profane my holy name with your gifts and with your idols. For in my holy mountain is the mountain of the height of Israel, says Adonai Yahweh. There all the house of Israel, all of them, shall serve me in the land. There I will accept them, and there I will require an offering and the first fruits of your offerings. With all your holy things, I will accept you as a pleasant aroma. When I bring you out from the peoples and gather you out from the countries in which you have been scattered, I will be sanctified in you, in the sight of the nations. You will know that I am Yahweh. When I bring you into Eretz Yisrael, into the country which I swore to give to your fathers, there you will remember your ways and all your deeds in which you have polluted yourselves. Then you will loathe yourselves in your own sight for all your evils that you have committed. You will know that I am Yahweh, when I have dealt with you for my name's sake, not according to your evil ways, nor according to your corrupt doings, you house of Israel, says Adonai Yahweh. Now the word of Yahweh came to me, saying, Son of man, set your face toward the south, and proclaim toward the south, and prophesy against the forest of the field in the south. Tell the forest of the south, hear the word of Yahweh. This is what Adonai Yahweh says, Behold, I will kindle a fire in you, and it will devour every green tree in you, and every dry tree. The burning flame will not be quenched, and all faces from the south to the north will be burned by fire in it. All flesh will see that I, Yahweh, have kindled it, and it will be quenched. It will not be quenched. Then I said, Adonai Yahweh, they say to me, Is he not a speaker of parables? The word of Yahweh came to me, saying, Son of man, set your face toward Jerusalem, proclaim toward the sanctuaries, and prophesy against Eretz Yisrael. Tell Eretz Yisrael, this is what Yahweh says, Behold, I am against you, and will draw my sword out of its sheath, and will cut off from you the righteous and the wicked. Seeing then that I will cut off from you the righteous and the wicked, therefore the sword, my sword, will go out of its sheath against all flesh from the south to the north. All flesh will know that I, Yahweh, have drawn my sword out of its sheath, and I will not return any more. Therefore sigh, you son of man. You shall sigh before their eyes with the breaking of your tights and with bitterness, and it shall be when they ask you, why do you sigh, that you shall say, because of the news, for it comes. Every heart will melt, all hands will be feeble, every spirit will faint, and all knees will be weak as water. Behold, it comes, and it shall be done, says Adonai Yahweh. And the word of Yahweh came to me, saying, Son of man, prophesy, say, this is what Yahweh says. A sword is sharpened, and also polished. It is sharpened to make a slaughter. It is polished that it may be as lightning. Should we then make mirth? The rod of my son condemns every tree. It is given to be polished, that it may be handled. The sword is sharpened, and it is polished, to give it into the hand of the killer. Cry and wail, son of man, for it is on my people. It is on all the princes of Israel. They are delivered over to the sword, with my people. Therefore beat your thigh, for there is a trial. What if even the rod that condemns will be no more, says Adonai Yahweh? You therefore, son of man, prophesy, and strike your hands together like the sword be doubled the third time, the sword of the fatally wounded. It is the sword of the great one who is fatally wounded, which enters into their rooms. I have set the threatening sword against all their gates, that their heart may melt and their stumblings be multiplied. Ah, it is made as lightning. It is pointed for the slaughter. Gather yourselves together, go to the right, set yourselves in array to the left. Wherever your face is set, I will also strike my hands together, and I will cause my wrath to rest. I, Yahweh, have spoken it. The word of Yahweh came to me again, saying, Also, son of man, appoint two ways, that the sword of the king of Babylon may come. They both will come out of one land. The mark out of a place, mark it out of the head of the way to the city. You shall appoint a way for the sword to come to Rabbah, of the children of Ammon, and to Judah, and to fortified Jerusalem. For the king of Babylon stood at the parting of the way, at the head of two ways, to use divination. He shook the arrows back and forth. He consulted the teraphim. He looked at the liver. In his right hand was the lot of Jerusalem, to set battering rams, to open the mouth in the slaughter, to lift up the voice with shouting, to set battering rams against the gates, to cast up mounds, to build forts. And it will be to them as false divination in their sight, who have sworn oaths to them. But he brings iniquity to memory, that they may be taken. Therefore, this is what Adonai Yahweh says, because you have caused your iniquity be remembered, in that your transgressions are uncovered, so then all your doings, your sins appear, because you have come to memory, you will be taken into the hand, you deadly, wounded, wicked one, the prince of Israel, whose day has come, in the time of the iniquity of the end. This is what Adonai Yahweh says, remove the turban and take off the crown. This will not be as it was. Exalt that which is low and humble that which is high. A ruin I will make of it. This also will be no more until he comes, whose right it is, and I will give it. And you, son of man, prophesy and say, this is what Adonai Yahweh says concerning the children of Ammon and concerning their reproach. A sword is drawn, and it is polished for the slaughter, to cause it to devour, that it may be as lightning. While they see for you false visions, while they divine lies to you, to lay you on the necks of the wicked who are deadly wounded, whose day has come in the time of the iniquity of the end. Cause it to return into the sheath, in the place where you were created, in the land of your birth. I will judge you. I will pour out my indignation on you. I will blow on you with the fire of my wrath. I will devour you into the hand of the brutish men, skillful to destroy. You will be fuel to the fire. Your blood will be in the middle of the land. You will be remembered no more, for I, Yahweh, have spoken it.